Rugby action for Northampton or Bedford, while the Football League matches involving Peterborough, Colchester, MK Dons, Southend and Northampton are all off.
There's a lot there, isn't there? Yeah. Just two games have survived. Norwich at home to Exeter tomorrow and Ipswich's match at Leicester on Sunday. Well, our clubs really have been battling with the elements all week.
The Yorkshire weather couldn't be worse for this great match of the day. The snow is coming down hard.
Bremner again, that's a nice one.
They used to play whatever the weather, no excuses. But the picture's changed. While the majority of matches this weekend are off, it's game on at Carrow Road. Undersol Heating's kept the turf defrosted for the last 17 years, so Norwich will face Exeter tomorrow.
Every time we have to use it, it is a, you know, several hundred pounds of gas bill comes in immediately after that. So, yes, it is expensive, but it's just so important to us and far less expensive than having to call games off.
Walsall resorted to a cheaper, more old-fashioned technique for their game with Norwich at Christmas. It didn't work. Frost sheets on at Stadium MK, but to little effect. No chance of any action. The pipework's in place for undersoil heating, but it isn't connected yet. The running costs are just too high.
It would have made very little difference. We've seen already this week games have gone at both Manchester City and the Arsenal stadiums that have undersoil heating. But with the weather forecast for the rest of the week, meaning that the snow outside the stadium, the state of the pavements, the state of the concourses, undersoil heating wouldn't have cured that at all.
Northampton Town left snow on the pitch to keep it insulated. The plan was working a treat until last night's frost. Last-ditch efforts to keep the game on proved to be in vain.
We're disappointed. A lot of effort, a lot of thought, a lot of time has gone into putting the trying to get the game on, and we were not able to finally keep the frost out.
So with not a blade of the green stuff in sight, scant chance of upsetting most groundsmen this weekend. Tom Williams, BBC Look East.
Well, if you've been struggling to keep warm this week, spare a thought for our feathered friends. With many ponds and lakes frozen over, it's been a really difficult time for birds and other wildlife.
And with freezing temperatures set to continue, they need our help more than ever. Our environment reporter Richard Daniel's been finding out how they're coping.
Today there was only one way to reach the RSPB's reserve at Snape on the Suffolk coast. A place effectively out of bounds to most visitors. We then abandoned four wheels for 4 feet.
Wow, what a sight.
It is, it's scenery to die for, and the wildlife out there is absolutely fantastic. We've got a massive range of different birds out there. We've got gulls, we've got ducks like widgeon and shell duck, we've got waders like redshank and golden plover out there, which are all using this really vital area to feed and stay alive, basically, in these really tough conditions.
With lakes frozen over, many birds have headed to the coast. Here, water still flows, the invertebrates in the mud providing extra food so vital to maintain body temperature.
You will have birds suffering more from mortality, so the problem is that they need to feed in order to keep alive, and if they can't access the food, then they will die off. And what the RSPB is encouraging people to do is to minimise disturbance to wildfowl and geese and swans and waders when they're out in the countryside.
For garden birds, extra food from feeders at this time can be a lifesaver.
Come on! Come on!
And it's not just the birds that Matt has his eye on.
These are our Manx Longton and Wiltshire Horn sheep, but they're fairly hardy and we're counting them every day to make sure they're all still here and giving them a few sheep nuts.
And down on the river, the coming days will be tough for the birds too. Richard Daniel, BBC Look East.
Well, the snow might have been hard week work this week for some of us, but if you are a husky dog, then it's great news.
Well, Mike Liggins was out early this morning in Thetford Forest with one of the region's husky racing teams.
It's early, and Debbie Windsor is taking her team of huskies for a run.
Yep.
Okay.
We're going for a ride!
For racing, Debbie uses a three-wheel rig, but for training, it's a quad bike with no engine. It works all year round and is a bit more practical than a sled. How do you steer? The dogs respond to voice commands.
It's ho to turn left, G to turn right, and OK to go straight on. And if you're feeling really ambitious, you can stay steady, stand and wait, and you hope you stop.
The huskies are exercised four times a week in the winter season. Today, the dogs do two-mile circuits, and they're even happy to pull a big load like me.
Absolutely wonderful. What a fantastic day to do it, and just an amazing experience. Who enjoys it more, you or them?
I wouldn't like to say it's a very close run thing, I think. Very close run. I mean, we all love it. As you know, we've just done 2 miles with the dogs there, and they're just absolutely raring to go again. You know, it's not enough.
We've had a fantastic morning. We've got one more thing to show you. Have a look at this one. This is Gladys. She's 9 weeks old. And how cute is she? Everyone say, ah. Mike Liggins, BBC Look East, Thetford Forest. Come on.
She is gorgeous. That is definitely the way to travel in this
weather,
absolutely,
isn't it? Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Lots of R's in the studio as well, particularly from the lady on my left here, Jules.
Some light relief from the weather, which I said isn't looking any better. Tonight with some more of your pictures. Thank you very much for sending them in. Have a great weekend.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye. We met in the winter.